Okay, you know that thing on a ladder to set the paint can or something? You know that little fold-out thing on a ladder? Well, I took the sides off of it. I'm going to drill out these rivets and take that top piece off. And I'm going to pop rivet this piece of aluminum in there. I'm going to take the wire brush to it and the maybe the belt sander, and we're going to pop rivet that right there. And then on the back side, let me step around here, that terminal box is going to go right in there.
Put this little step that used to be on that ladder all cleaned up.
It is cleaned up a bit. Hell, I should work for NASA. So I pop riveted this ram mount onto this tower, and I took the top portion of the ram mount, which was a long, or the bottom portion, you can flip them over either way. I cut some off with a bandsaw and ground it down. I gotta touch it up with black paint. But fish finder's gonna go right on there, and you can tilt that however you want it. It is pop riveted on there. Not only does it make the tower more sturdy, but it gives a nice place for that terminal block. Okay, I got my rocket launchers that I bought that are going to go right here. But then I took, and this is a, it's actually the poles to old umbrellas. That's an old umbrella there. And I had two umbrellas. So I took the bottom poles and I cut them off. And I'm going to put a bracket here, pop rivet, and a pop rivet, a bracket there. And that'll be a rocket launcher on that side. One down on this side. And then I'll have my store-bought ones over there. Well, then I made, out of the remaining pieces of pipe, I made two more for the sides. Because I don't think I'm going to use these stupid rod holders that I bought. There's just nowhere to put them. You gotta have brackets. There's nowhere to get them above this rail, or I would have to sink them in there, and it's just, I'm not gonna use them. I'm gonna make these rocket launchers. So I made some brackets out of some aluminum, and the brackets are going to go over and pop rivet. And these are the bottom brackets because I can only do half. I'm going to pop rivet in there into that support. So two is going to go on. These are going to go on top. I'm going to polish them up. So I'll have two rocket launchers there as well. So that'll give me six. So I actually got my carpeted piece of paneling in there. And it's just a piece of paneling, the carpet on it, and I got my bolts ground off with the Dremel. So we're going to go ahead and put the tackle boxes in. Okay, on Little Miss Muffet's box, I drilled holes and zip tied this little, it's a little zipper cargo pouch. You can get it at AutoZone or Advance or an RV place. It's just it's got little pouches here with stretchy straps, and it's got six pouches, and then it's got the big pouch. So she's got that for her. But I noticed this wants to pop out. You see that? Because I got the weight of that carpeted board there. So, you know, I got those stupid kayak cleats that were real tiny. And so I whacked off the ends of them with the bandsaw and ground them down. And I'm going to put those little cleats right there to keep that thing from popping, to keep that thing from popping out. Okay, so that keeps that from popping out. Well, The John boat modifications are just about finished. We're going to go ahead and do a little update. Get out here and see if I can't show you this tower. There's what the thing looks like. Let's go on the other side. So, there she be. We'll see. We'll see how well she does on the water. Let me go ahead and explain some of the things I did. Well, in the first video, we did the rails. Let's see, we did the boards. We did the armor coat waterproofing. We did the carpet. We put this little thing in for little Miss Muffet. She's got herself a little carpeted board in the bottom. I gave her a little zipper pouch, zip tied it in, drilled some holes. It's also got some stretchy little pouches, six of them. This thing kept coming off, so I took and cut the ends off of two plastic cleats and put that down there so that thing can't come off, and then put a little stretchy bungee there. I put her a little stretchy water bottle, a holder there. I pop riveted it in. I gave her a movable plastic mount that I had because I don't think she's going to like these rocket launchers I made. If you're looking for heat shrink terminals and a little heat shrink gun, I'll put the link for that. I think that's like $9 and pretty good deal. We made ourselves a camera mount. I got a little bit of that video I'm going to insert. Okay, so there's the camera mount. This is what I've done. I put a sleeve, drilled an inch hole, and I put a sleeve, a plastic sleeve in there. Then I took a pipe, and I had one more of these brackets from this luggage rack that I made a rail out of, and I pop ribbed that into this pipe. I put a piece of rubber behind it so it would cushion it. And then I slightly bent the bottom, kind of like what I did when I put the rails on. And then I took this old tripod, it was one of those mini tripods, and I cut the bottom off, sunk it down in here, pop riveted it in. That's just where the two meet, and I didn't want any water getting in there. So then I'll be able to turn, tighten, and use this for a camera tripod. I got a folding Trophy Series collapsible landing net. I'll put the link up for that. I held it in my mouth. It's a pretty good net. So it folds out and locks into place with a little locking. So there should be. And then the arm extends out as well. So we got one of those. We made some rocket launcher side rod holders. Those are pieces off of a umbrella. That's the umbrella pipe. And then this is the little piece that was on top of that little ladder step that we used for our terminal box that was around it. And I just cleaned it off with a Dremel and a little brush attachment. We got our tower secured in with little bent pipes. Got four secured in. Got the front secured in. Got it mounted down to the deck. And then we have our rail off the salvage boat for support and our swim bars off the salvage boat for support. We got our store-bought rocket launchers, well actually off of eBay they were used, for my little trolling rods. The two top ones are trolling rods. The two bottom ones are just rods. We got our back line. We got our cup holder inserted. Oh, and I also put another cup holder. Top riveted. Well, no, I screwed that one in for a cup, and I put a little brace underneath it. This thing here, you know, you're probably saying, well, you got everything but a live well. I don't know, I covered that too. I got a little wing nut here. Let's take that wing nut off. I have a little bracket that this little arm, I bent a hinge around, took a piece of aluminum pipe, put a eye hook in it with a little pulley, floating live well. And that's how it's going to do. I've got a little cleat there. You see that cleat? And that's going to drop down into the water. And it's really neat. I'll put the link up for that. So anyway, I held that in my mouth again. And you just push down to drop the fish in. And you can drop it down below the boat.
And of course, I've got the minnow bucket that I use. You know, the little Frayabil. I've used it quite a few times. I got a little pump in it, and it works well.
I put two little eye hooks. They go together. One has a bolt, one has a receiver. And so I can hook my fish grips in it with these little carabiners. So I put some bungee cord on this fish grip and put a carabiner in it. And got two of those there. Over there I got the same thing, and I got a pair of scissors in it. We got my little cooler, little Miss Muffet got me. We got the bilge pump, we got the fire extinguisher back here. We got our fish finder mounted on with a ram mount. Those ram mounts are awesome. I did pop rivet in, then I spray painted the pop rivets black. What else have we got on this thing? We got the green canopy. I have the white and black one, but there was a hole in the white and black one, so I'm not sure I'm going to use it. It's actually cut to go all the way to the end. So I got the green tarp on there now. I put a little bungee cargo net up there. I still have to put the spotlights on and the LED lights. Spotlights are going to be facing out. I think I might put one on the front, one on the back. I might put two on the front and get two different ones for the back. And then our LED strip lights, we have four of those. I think I might just use two. They're bright as heck. We'll see what they look like. We're going to put those on a canopy facing down. And that is all going to be on those little switches there. And I'll put the link up for that switch panel if I still have it. It's a little switch panel. And then we have our terminal, fish finder. So we have our navigation light that we can raise up above the canopy. It's got it. I cut it down, but it still is able to raise and lower. We have our horn with a switch. Like I said, anybody gets near me within 25 feet, they gonna get a blast. Cause growing up in my dad's John boat, we flipped that thing several times. What else we got? What else we got going? Oh, the box. Let me show you the box. So the box, I put a knob here so I can lift it when I'm in there. Got stuck on that pole. I put a knob there. I have my I have my meter for my battery that I drilled a hole and put a switch there and put the meter there. That little compartment is the little credit card shredder from a paper shredder, the little cup that holds the credit cards and CDs and stuff when you want to shred credit cards and CDs. We never used it, so now it's going to be for my water shoes. If I still got a link for them water shoes, I'll put them up too. We have our solar panel, waterproof solar panel, 12 volt, 5 amp, trickle charger. I put her a USB charger in for her MP3 player. We have all those drilled and mounted. Then I touched up those bolts with black paint. I did get a tray to sit on top of my tackle boxes. I did wrap the wire coming out through the bottom with that wrap, and then I also put some regular PVC wrap around it to protect the battery terminal wires. And then I got this, and in here we got sunscreen, we got two flares, we have trash bags, we have our ore holders, we have a whistle just in case the horn stops, and we have extra bolts for that mount I made up there, plus we have extra wing nuts for the battery. You always got to carry extra wing nuts for the battery, because if you lose one when you're out on the water, for some reason one comes undone, you got some more. So there's like 8 wing nuts in there. What else we got? There's something else. No, that's it. So that's what's in there so far. We got a boonie hat just in case the sun gets us, some hand wipes, our emergency sign, and in all that, in all these cases, we also have our first aid kit with our sting, epinephrine, in case someone gets stung. Anyway, we have medicines, antibiotic salve, Neosporin, tweezers, we have a needle for if you get a briar stuck in you or a splinter. We've got Soothe-a-Sting swabs, iodine swabs, blood clotting swabs, antiseptic swabs, scissors, a flashlight in there, thermometer, a thing of alcohol, a bunch of bandages, a lighter just in case, all kinds of stuff in there. So we've got the bases covered on that. Oh, we got to turn it over to see some more. We got some hand sanitizer in there, and we got some hot hand pockets for your hands in case your hands get cold. So anyway, we have our first aid kit in that. So we've got the box. I wasn't going to do it, but then after I started thinking about everything I wanted to put in the boat, and all those little cases only weigh 12 pounds. The battery weighs probably, what, 25, you think? Maybe 35. I didn't weigh the battery. So we've got about 50 pounds there total. So it's not too much. And I need that extra weight because the thing was kind of wobbly. So that'll kind of settle it down, should. We have our line, so I can hook that up so I can launch by myself. We have our dock line. I got those at Home Depot. They sell nice dock line, believe it or not. We have my anchor. I'm going to put I got a little plastic I showed you in. I don't know if I'm put it in one of the videos or not. I got a little plastic tray. It's actually hard plastic tray. It was a lid off of a toolbox kit that I'm going to put a piece of rubber in, and we're going to use the anchor right there. What else? I think
I got a nest of wasps. You see that? They're in that door. One got me yesterday. They are in the door, down in the top. Little bastards. So, one got me right in the back of my head. Look, they're going up in those channels. Isn't that something? I bet every single one of those have bees nest in it. Well, as long as they don't feel threatened, but I don't know why one got me yesterday. So there she be. She's not quite finished. We still got to put our lights on. But once we get the lights on, she's ready for the water. She's gonna... Oh, no, she's not ready for the water. Forgot about the stabilizers. The stabilizers are going in. I haven't... here they are. To get the big ones, I had to get used ones to get the big, heavy-duty crab pot floats. These are... Let's see how long they are. They're 15, I think. They're 15 inches long. And 6 inches wide. So they're a little bit bigger than the 4.5 by 11s that everybody else is selling. So we're gonna paint them up. We got some Krylon Max. It's for plastic and paint and primer. We got some of that green, kind of match the boat. We're gonna paint those up, cut the cords out of them. We're gonna paint those up, and then we've got our adapters right here. These adapters are going in. And they're going on our crutches, these heavy duty crutches with a solid handle, and they're going to go right above this bar here and out. So I'm going to work on those this evening. Okay, so the stabilizers are glued and have to sit overnight. Just like everybody else makes them. I put PVC to them. Although, I shot some of that spray foam. You know, the great stuff spray foam. I shot some down the center of those things before I shoved the PVC, 3/4 inch PVC through there. And that way, the PVC ain't gonna move at all. So that was my little trick, and you can see once it started to get tacky, I just pushed it down with my fingers, and that will get hard by tomorrow. I did lightly sand these crab pots. Well, I got the stabilizer first coat painted. I think they're gonna come out pretty decent. They look like everybody else's canoe and kayak, and just one guy has John Boat stabilizers. That John Boat's skinny, so I think it's going to be fine. I think it's going to work out just perfect. So it's LED spots. I'll put the link in. I think the link's in the first video as well. And so I think it's a link for those LED lights too. Well, we got everything hooked up. Got the navigation lights also. Got all the lights hooked up. Now, I am going to put a spot on the back as well. There were two in that package, and I got another spot. I just haven't had a chance to make the bracket. So, everything is wired up. Only thing left to do is put the stabilizers on, and that's it. Unless I get a Bimini. I think it's going to look great. I think it's going to do great.